Hello students, today we are continuing with this chapter sexual reproduction in flowering plants. In that chapter, today we are discussing the gynoecium. It is also called pistil. The gynoecium or pistil represents the female reproductive structure of a flower. The pistil, it may be single, they are called as monocapillary, or it may be many numbers, they are called as multicapillary. So, monocapillary or multicapillary. So many numbers, they are called as multicapillary, or it may be single one, they are called as monocapillary. Well, the gynoecium, that is the pistil, are many numbers, they are multicapillary structure. At the time, they are either they are fused ones, they are called as syncarpous, or they are free one. They are not fused, free one. They are called as apocarpous. So, in multicapillary, the pistils are fused ones, they are called as syncarpous. If they are free ones, they are called as apocarpous. So this is about the general introduction about gynoecium. That is, gynoecium or the pistil, if they are single one present in a flower, they are called as monocapillary flower. If there are many numbers, carpels or pistils are present, they are called as multicarpellary. So in multicarpellary, there is the carpels are, if fused, they are called as syncarpous. Either they are fused or they are free one. If they are free one, they are called as apocarpous. Now, the pistil or the gynoecium contains three parts. The gynoecium or the pistil contains three parts. They are the stigma, style and ovary. Can draw the general structure of this gynoecium. So this is the stigma, this is style, this is ovary, and it will be situated on the base, is called the hypothalamus. Now, this thalamus or hypothalamus, these are the different parts which are on that base. The ovary is situated, then the all the complete pistil is situated. Now, the pistil have the three parts. One is the stigma. What is stigma means? It is the landing part It is the landing platform of the pollen grains. It is the landing platform for pollen grains. The second one is the style. Style is the cylinder and elongated part present near the or beneath the stigma. So, style is the elongated cylinder part present beneath the stigma. That third one, ovary. Ovary is the basal part of the pistil or the gynoecium. This basal part is the bulgar part. It is the basal bulgar part present in the pistil. Basal bulged part of pistil. So that is called as the ovary. So there are three parts. Stigma is the landing platform for the pollen grains. Style is an elongated slender part which is present beneath the stigma. Third, ovary, it is the basal bulged part of the style, sorry, pistil. Now, the ovary contains what? The within the ovary, there is a ovary cavity is present. So, inside the ovary, there is a ovary cavity is present. That cavity called as locule. Okay, remember that ovary, inside the ovary there is a ovarian cavity is present. That cavity is called as the locule. On the locule placenta is located. So within this locule, placenta means what? The placenta is the cushion like structure. Means it is soft one. Cushion like structure which is located. So here the ovarian cavity is present. This is the cavity, compartments are present. Within that, this is the placenta is present. Over this placenta, there is a ovules are arranged. So from the placenta, ovules are arisen. So the ovary is the basal bulged part of pistil which is containing the ovarian cavity called locule. Within the locule, the placenta is present. That placenta containing the, from the placenta, there is a ovules are arisen. So this is about the general structure. Then the number of ovules in the ovary are maybe single are present. They are called as some examples of one ovule containing the flower such as the wheat, the mango, etc. Single ovule within the ovary, a single ovule is present. They are called as the, they are, some examples are wheat or mango, or they are many numbers are present. The many ovules are present. Examples are papaya. You remember that papaya plant, papaya fruit. Within that, we can observe the many numbers of the seeds or the ovules. These are seeds are ovules are nothing but the premature seeds only. Then papaya, another examples you can take watermelon. You can take other examples also. The tomato also have the examples of mini ovules. Now we will discuss the another bit in this gynoecium, that is the structure of ovule or the megasporangium. Ovule is also called as the megasporangium or megasporangia. Plural word is megasporangia. Singular it is called the megasporangium. So this structure of megasporangium or the ovule, which is carries 5 more questions. It is very important for the exam point of view. Before the explaining about the structure of ovule, you have to draw the diagram of structure of anatropous ovule. There are different types of ovules are present. Anatropous ovules are the one examples we can take in this session. You have to draw the diagram. Within this ovule, there is an embryo sac is present. Now we label it. This is the funicle. This part is called as hilum. Micropylar pole. Micropyle. Outer intermediate.
inner entrepreneur.
Çalazapur, so these are the some of the labelings we have to done. This is the our drawing about the structure of Anatropous oval. Or megasporangium. It's important for thymus. Now we have to explain this structure. So the ovule is a small structure arises from the placenta by a stalk called the funicle. So from the in the ovary, a small structure is the ovule which is connected to the placenta by a stalk called the funicle. Then the inter between the bridge between the body of the ovule, the body of the ovule and the funicle is part is called as the hilum. So hilum is nothing but the part which fuses the both funicle as well as the ovule's body. Now so at the one end of there is a the sorry the ovule is covered by a two layer protecting covering is present, that is called as the integuments. So these integuments are completely covered except at the tip of the ovule, that where is a small opening is present, that is called as the micropyle. So ovule is covered by the two layer protective covering which is covered completely except at the tip of the ovule, that is called as the there is a opening is called the micropyle. And the micropylar pore opposite to this micropylar pore there is a chalazal pore is present, or it is a basal part of the is also called as the basal part of the ovule. Opposite to the micropylar pole there is a chalazal pole is present, it is also called as the basal part of the ovule. Now so the integuments are two in numbers, outer integuments and the inner integuments. Within these integuments there is a mass of cells are present, they are called as the nucellus. So there is a mass of cells are present within the integuments, they are called as nucellus. This nucellus containing the cells containing the reserve food material. So the cells of the nucellus containing the reserve food materials required during the germination of the seeds. Okay, next within the nucellus there is a the embryo sac is for the it is also called as female gametophyte. So within the nucellus there is a embryo sac is present, it is also called as the female gametophyte, which is formed by the the single megaspore undergo meiosis to form the embryo sac or the female gametophyte. So we have to explain another word, another time, the structure of anatropous ovule, which is very important. Explain the structure of anatropous ovule with neat labeled diagram. So you have to explain like that, the finicle. So first of all, the structure of anatropous ovule, in that ovules is attached to the placenta, they start called finicle. The finicle and the ovule's body are fused by a part called hilum. Then the ovules are covered by a protective covering called as integuments. These are two in numbers, outer integument and the inner integuments. These integuments are completely covered the ovule except at the tip of the ovule called micropyle, where the small opening is present, that is called the micropyle. Opposite to the micropylar pole, there is a basal part is present called as chalaza pole. Then within the integuments, there is a mass of cells are present, they are called as nucellus. The cells of nucellus containing the reserve food materials. So within the nucellus, the small megaspore, a single megaspore, are developed by a meiosis to the embryo sac, or it is also called as female gametophyte. So within the nucellus, there is a megaspore, single megaspore undergo meiosis to form the embryo sac, or it is also called as female gametophyte. So here today we are discussing complete the gynoecium. What are the parts of the gynoecium are present? Then the structure of anatropous ovule. Tomorrow we discuss the process of megaspore and sporogenesis, and as well as the how the formation of embryo sac and the distribution of cells within the embryo sacs will be discussed. Thank you.